Hello student, today I am going to teach you heap sort algorithm. Heap sort algorithm is one of the most popular sorting technique because it shows a very stable behavior. Because it sorts even small amount or huge amount, it doesn't depend. It sorts the data whether in reverse order or ascending order, descending order. It shows a very stable behavior. It takes a time n log n in comparison to the selection sort, bubble sort, insertion sort, which were of the order of n square. It means they took so much long time in comparison to the heap sort algorithm, which takes n log n time. But before, in last lecture, I have taught you about the procedure of building a heap and heapifying. In last lecture, I have told you about the build heap and heapifying procedure that are used and the algorithm also. And now today I shall explain you heap sort algorithm. Before understanding heap sort algorithm, you must know the process of the build heap and heapify procedure, because these are the functions that will be used in the heap sort algorithm. So here I have used two functions, the build heap function and max heapify function. In last lecture I have already told you about these their algorithms and their functionalities, how they work. But in this lecture, I give you just brief idea about it, that how they work. In heapify function, the first of all, heap is the binary tree in which there can be of max heap or min heap. In general, we considered it as a max heap, in which the parent node value is greater than the value of its children. This is a must condition that must be followed throughout the tree, that every parent node should have value higher than its children value. Besides this, the second property there are two functions in it, build max heap function and max heapify. Heapify functions make sure that at each node, this property, that parent value is greater than its child node. If it is not so, then the root node value is compared with the left child and right child. Which one is among these three, which one is the largest is placed at the root node and the root node, and it is swapped with the root node value, and then the root node shifts to the position of the largest node values. And at that position, we run the procedure of heapify again or iteratively, because whenever swapping takes place, the largest node comes at the root, and the previous root node goes to the node which has taken place of the root node. So this process is iteratively applied at the previous at the location where the swapping has taken place. So I have discussed it in the last lecture. So I shall discuss it when I shall discuss the numerical again. So don't worry if you are not getting it right now. And I shall take an example and I shall repeat the procedure many times in this question. So you will get an idea about it. And next procedure was build heap. Running the heapify procedure through the n by 2 nodes, starting from the n by 2th node to the root node, max heapify the complete binary tree. This is procedure is called the build heap procedure. So in simple word, we can say that running the heapify function over n by 2 number of node, starting from the n by 2th node to the root node, is called the build heap procedure. So now we are starting the heap sort algorithm. In heap sort algorithm, first we make sure that the given tree satisfies the binary heap, the heap property. For that, we run a build max heap function, which apply the function heapify function over the n by 2 number of node, starting from the n by 2th position to the root node. After that, we start a for loop for the length which starts from the last node up to the second number of node. We do not run this procedure at the first node. Why? I am going to explain. This will be clear to you in the third line. After that, what we do after heapifying, we exchange the last element with the root element. After that, second element. Here I have told you that last element is swapped with the second element, because in this heap size A is heap size A minus 1. Because what we do, we have swapped the first element with the last element, and after that swapping, what we do, the root element is heap size is equal to heap size minus 1. It means when we perform swapping, the root node takes the place of the last node and the last node becomes the root node. After this, we reduce the size of the heap by 1 value. It means the root element, the previous root element goes to the last position and it is removed. And after removing, the last element which have taken the place of the root element is heapified again. Okay, is heapified again to make sure that after this swapping, the heap property are still maintained in the heap. If it is not clear to you, then I am going to take an example with which you will clearly understand that. So I am taking a heap 19, 17, 13, 11, 10, 12, 6, 5, 7, 4, 3, and 2. Okay. First of all, check that this is a heap, because first line was build max heap. So we shall check at n by 2. There are 3, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. N is equal to 12. So we shall run the build heapify function, in which we run the heapify function over the n by 2 number of node, starting from the n by 2th to the first position. So n by 2 is equals to 6. So we shall check the function from 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We shall check that at these node, max heap property is being satisfied. Here 10 is greater than 4 and 3, its children node. At 12 is greater than its children 2. 10 is greater than its children 4 and 3. 11 is greater than its children 5 and 7. 13 is greater than its children 12 and 6. 17 is greater than its children 11 and 10. And 19 is greater than its children 17 and 13. So at all the n by 2, I mark this node, 6 node, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The heapify condition, max heapify condition is being satisfied. Or these nodes are already heapified, so this is already a max heap. Now for running the max heap operation, what we do, we exchange these element, the root element with the last element. We exchange the root element with the last element. In the after this, what will it will become like this? 2, 17, 13, 11, 10, 5, 7, 4, 3, 12, 6, and 19. Okay. Now we shall reduce the size of the heap by one value. So this node will be eliminated. This node will be deleted, because in the line I have written that heap size equal to heap size minus 1, and we shall store this value into an array. There are 3, 3, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 values. So there are 12 values. So this will be the 19. Okay. After placing this 19, heap size has been reduced by 1. After that, we shall run the max heapify at root node. Max heapify a1. Okay. After max heapifying, we shall check that 2 is less than 17, 2 is less than 13, but 17 is greater than 13. So swapping will take place between here. After this swapping, 2 will come here. After this swapping, 17, 2, 13, 11, 10, 12, 6, 5, 7, 4, 3. Okay, one element. So again, here swapping will take place because 11 is greater than 2 and 10 is also greater than 2, but 11 is greater than 10. So swapping will take place. After this swapping, now 2 will come at this place. I am just rubbing it here. After the swapping, the 11 will go here and 2 will come here. After this, again, 2 between 2, 5 is greater than 2, 7 is greater than 2. But 7 is greater than 5, so largest is 7. So swapping will take place here. And after this swapping, this tree will, heap will look like this. 17, 13, 11, 7, 5, 2, 3, 12, and 6, right? So 2 has shifted at this place. Now every node is satisfying the property of the node. There is, it is already heapified. Okay. So after this, we shall repeat the procedure that first node will be swapped with the last node. So after this swapping, what will happen? 17 and 13. AI will be exchanged with the AI, the A last element, which is exchanged with first element. After this swapping, 13 will go here and 17 will be here. After the swapping, 17 AI with A1. Okay, after swapping, we will eliminate the last element 17, and after eliminating 17, it will be placed here and the heap will look like this. Okay, now 3, after this, the heap will look like this. 3, 11, 13, 7, 10, 12, 6, 5, 2, 4. Last element has been removed because heap size equal to heap size minus 1. So heap size is A equals to heap size A minus 1. Minus 1. Okay. So after this, again we shall check that the AI max heapify AI node. Yahan again max heapify AI. AI A1. Aapko A1. After max heapifying A1, swapping will take place here. 3 and 13. 3 and 11 because, sorry, 3 and 13 is greater than this. So swapping will be take place between 3 and 13 because 3 is smaller than 13. When 3 will shift here, again 3 is smaller than 12 and 3 is less than 6. So again the swapping will take place, and after this swapping the heap will look like this. After the swapping, heap will look like this. 13, 11, 12, 3, 6, 7, 10, 5, 2, and 4. Right? Now the heap is satisfying the property of max heap, or it is a build. Yeah, after running the build max heap procedure, it is already satisfying the property of build max heap, or it is heapified. So after this, we shall again repeat the procedure. We shall perform exchange operation. After this exchange, AI with A1, and after this, this will become 13. So, okay, so 13 and 3. 10, 4. Okay. After this swapping, it will be like this. And we shall remove the last element. And remove the last element. So, and heap size equal to minus 1. Yeah, this will become like 4. 11, 12, 7, 10, 3, 6, 5, 2. And after the swapping, 13 will be placed here. Okay. And 13, here I am writing 13 by dotted line and removed. Okay. So again we shall compare it. 12 is greater than 4 and greater than swapping will take place here. And after that, again 6 is swapping will take place between, as 4 is less than 6. So after this, the swapping, the heap will become like this. 12, 11, 6, 3, 4, 7, 10, 5, 2. Right? Now, we shall again, this is already satisfying the max heap property. And after that, again, we shall swap the two numbers. And after swapping, it will convert, become like this. Sorry, 2, 11, 6, 7, 10, 5, and in place of 2, the new number will be 12. Okay, here 3 and 4. Now this will be removed. We have removed. Okay, after this removal, we shall check that this 2 is satisfying the property of max heap or not. 2 is less than 11 and less than 6, but 11 is greater than 6, so swapping will take place here. And after the swapping, when 2 will shift to this place, 2 is less than 7, 2 is less than 10, but 10 is greater than 7, so swapping will take place here. So after this, 11, 10, 7, 2, 6, 3, 4, 5, right? One by one, in each iteration, one element is being removed from the list. As in the last iteration, 12 has been removed, so it will be placed in an empty array of size equal to the size of array. We are just placing the element, and here the element are one by one, the element are arranging itself in descending order. Okay, and this way again we shall repeat the same procedure. This swapping will take place. After this swapping, I am just writing it here to, as the procedure is the same, so just I am just rubbing this 11. So 5 will go there and 11 will come here, and I am removing we shall reduce the heap size by 1, heap size equal to heap size minus 1. So after this removal, so I have explained two operation in the same figure. I have deleted two numbers after the swapping. Because here I have swapped with the 5 with 11. I have swapped. I draw another diagram so that you do not get confused of it, because of the, this was the diagram. After the swapping, it becomes like 6, 7, 2, 3, and 4, and 11 goes here, and this 11 is been removed. Okay, after removal I placed it in the list, and after, when I shall again make sure that this is satisfying the heap property. Max heapify the root node. Max heapifying the root node, we get that the 5 is less than 10 and 5 is less than 6, but 10 is greater than 6. So here the swapping will take place, and again when 5 will come here, it will be it is smaller than 7, so again a swapping will take place. So after the swapping, the heap will become like this: 10 7 5 2 6 3 and 4. Okay, right? So again after this, the last element will be swapped with the first element. So I am rubbing this portion. After the swapping, after the swapping, this will be 4, 7, 6, 5, 2, 3, and 10, and 10 will be removed. So it, after removal, it will be placed here, and now we shall make run the heapify function at root node or a1. Here 7 is greater than 4 and 6 also, so swapping will take place. Here 4 is also smaller than 5, so swapping will take place. So after this, it will look, convert into this heap in this form: 7, 5, 4, 2, 6, and 3. Okay, this is, after this conversion, we shall repeat the procedure. After the swapping, 3, 5, 6, 4, 2, and 7. Again, 7 will be removed and will be placed here. After this will become 3, 5, 6, 4, and 2. Now again, running the heapify function at root node. heapify function at root node, 3 is less than 5, 3 is less than, sorry, 3 is less than, okay, 3 function. Okay, 3 is 5 less than 5, 3 is less than 6. So, but 6 is greater than 5, so swapping will take place here. And after this, 6, 5, 3, 4, 2. Okay. Again, after this, the swapping will take place. After this swapping, 2, 5, 3, 4, and 6. This 6 will be removed. This 6 will be removed. After this removal, this will be placed here. And after this, running the heapify procedure, 2 is less than 5, 2 is less than 3, plus 5 is greater than 3, so swapping will take place here. And again, 2 is smaller than 4, the swapping will take place. So this will become like this, 5, 4, 3, and 2, right? Okay, so after this, now we shall repeat the procedure. The swapping will take place between root node and last node. So after this, 2, 4, 3, and 5. Now the 5 will be removed and will be placed here. 5. And after this, we shall run the heapify function at root node. Here, after heapifying, 4 is greater than 2 and 4 is also greater than 3. So it will become like this, 4, 2, and 3. Right, here again these two elements will be, first element with the last element swapped together. After this, 3, 2, and 4, and 4 will be removed and will be placed here. After this, we are left with the just two elements. So again heapifying, it's satisfying the criteria, 3, 2. So 3, 2, it's already in the form of heap. So after swapping, 2 and 3, and 3 will be removed, will be placed here, and we are left with the single element. Okay, and at last it will also be placed here. So by running the heap sort, we have sorted the data into the ascending order like this. This is the very simple procedure, and so there are just two space, first build heap and exchange the first element with the last element, and after the swapping, reduce the size of the heap by value 1, and when you reduce the size, now perform the heap, apply the heapify function at the root node. So this function, this is the procedure of heap sort. Now the complexity of the heap sort. Complexity of the heap sort, basically heap is of the size log n, and at each step you take, basically there are n number of items, depending on the number of items, for each item you are running the heapify function, so it takes n into log n time to execute. So the complexity of the heap sort is n log n in best case, average case, and the worst case. That's all about the heap sort. Thank you.